Family Feud, weekdays at 4:30. Trust your love again. You broke my heart in two, babe.
Taxi.
Hey, Becca.
Hey, Matt, what's up?
This music you're playing, it's way cool, Dan.
Gotta live a life of pain to sing the blues, Matt. But I think you already know that.
Tragic.
Books tell you about the history of the world, but the blues tell you about the history of the soul. You must be joking. You don't want that CD.
But Dan, it's great. I heard it.
Your call. Just give me my $13.99.
What's wrong with it?
What's wrong with it? They rip off Jimi Hendrix licks, and then they sample them through the same club. They're grave robbers. Now, this is a different story. This is hot. This is happening. And this is why they call them classic records.
I know.
Hey, you get that Stone Deaf album?
The new one?
Yeah, the one that's in the paper.
Yeah. Cash or charge?
Oh, cash.
Danny Webster, you're under arrest.
Hey, Matt, what's
wrong? Violation of City Ordinance 476.62, selling obscene material within the city limits.
What are you talking about?
You're also in violation of County Ordinance 837.98 and 837.99, trafficking of obscene material and possession of obscene material. Now step out around the counter.
You got to be crazy, man. Man, no, hold on.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have a right to an attorney. You can't afford an attorney, one will be appointed to you from the court. Let's go. I'll never be the same no more.
There's an Alabama in the Marchex name. Molly is a singer in a band. Desmond says to Molly, girl, I like your face.
In a couple of years, they have built a whole sweet home with a couple of kids running.
Life goes on, life goes on.
I'm sorry.
You'll have your chance, Miss Thatcher.
Does this come out of my 5 minutes?
No. Please continue.
As I was saying, some of these so-called artists are nothing more than pornographers. We have laws against industrial pollution in our skies. We have laws against littering on our streets. We have laws against poison in our food. I say it's high time for laws that protect us from the slime on the airwaves.
Class? Your closing argument.
I wonder how my opponent would feel if he woke up tomorrow morning and discovered that the government had indeed protected him from the slime on the airwaves. Not only that, but also the slime in the movie theaters, on his television, at the newsstands, in the library. How would he feel if his favorite books were suddenly called pornography? If he couldn't read Mark Twain or Kurt Vonnegut? Because that's what's happening right now. If you give the government the right to censor anything, they can censor everything. Because who's to say what is pornographic?
Excellent rebuttal! Very good, thank
you. Last.
Morning, wild thing. Dream about me?
Kent, hi.
I brought some breakfast. Some hot, tender morsels. Nice, juicy eats for two, shall we?
That's really sweet of you, but I can't. The agency called me for a job this morning. Gotta get downtown. I'm late.
Downtown? It's exactly where I was heading. Just slide your biscuits into the saddle and we'll,
Kent, I can't. Look, I'm dressed. Look, I'm really, really late.
I've been doing some major thinking, and I think I should move in with you.
Move in with me?
Well, yeah, I mean, my place is too small for both of us at the same time.
Kent, look, we never decided. Look, I'm late. We'll talk later, okay?
Yeah. What time should I bring my stuff over?
No, we're not living together.
Well, no, not yet, but by the time you get home.
No.
Look. What's the point, huh? I mean, you and me, we got this great thing going, but if we're not together, then what's the point?
Why are you doing this to me right now? We'll talk about this later.
Yeah, well, maybe there won't be a later.
So, how do we do at lunch today?
Now, let me put it this way. Don't quit your day job.
This is my day job.
Well, now, don't quit your night job. At least one of us should be making a living.
Mr. T, I just don't get it. Everything we serve here is the freshest you can get. I mean, our prices are more than reasonable. And Hansi, he flips the best burgers in 6 states. Now, I just don't get it.
You pay her to talk like that?
No, I don't pay her to talk at all. It's a bonus.
Well, she's right, you know. One of the best burgers and shakes I've had in a long time.
Well, thanks. Why don't you spread the word?
Darn right I will. You know, what you really need is one terrific restaurant review.
Yeah, tell me, who'd review a place like this?
No, I mean it. Here. Wally Nickerson, Tri-State Publications. I'm in space. Advertising sales. But I could,
Yeah, well... Thanks, but no thanks, Mr. Nickerson. I can't really afford any space right now.
Oh, no. Well, not yet. Maybe. Our Blue Ribbon Restaurant Guide covers this whole area. What I'm saying is maybe I could get our food critic, Gigi Gourmet, down here.
I've read some of Gigi's reviews. Sometimes they can be pretty nasty.
Right. But a big following. Could do wonders for you.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Nickerson, you get Gigi, what's-his-name, Gourmet down here, and your next meal's on the house.
I'll hold you to it.
Okay, we can put some around here.
Over here. Hey, what's all this?
The DA and a bunch of city councilmen are coming down to the stylist to confiscate records. Dad, it's the First Amendment. There's this fascist parents group that wants to clean up the music world. They can't do it. It's like... to Gestapo, and we have to stop them.
Is take the flyers down.
Dad, don't you believe in the First Amendment?
Doesn't make any difference what I believe in. This is a business. This is my business. Take the flyers down.
Dad.
Besides, I'm not so sure I like the idea of some of this stuff being so easily available to my 15-year-old daughter. So, can I get anybody a burger?
Thanks, but there's still a lot of naked foam poles out there.
Yeah, thanks anyway, Mr. Thatcher. Oh, I don't know. I think I'll go for one.
Tyler.
What?
I think your generation was right. Never trust anyone over 30. Dan, you're here. I can't believe this town. Where is their moral outrage? Isn't there someone, anyone, who'll stand up for the Constitution? Boy, Rosa Parks had it easy. All she had to do was get on a bus.
Easy? You guys really think Rosa Parks had it easy? All I had to do was put up my store.
What?
Yeah, I had to put up my store so I could make bail.
Dan, I'm sorry. But if you didn't do it, who knows where they'll stop? Our freedoms are on the line here.
Maxie, let me tell you about freedoms. I'm the only one in my whole family that ever owned anything. And that took 20 years. Now, that's what I call real freedom. My family eats. We live nice. I take care of my mother. Man, I just wish all this stuff would disappear and go away.
Dan, are you saying you want us to stop the rally?
You gotta do what you see fit. But do it because you think it's right, not for me. I'm doing it for jazz and blues because that's my life.
Jazz and blues?
Have you listened to this? I mean, this isn't even music. It's dirty, it's sexist, it's degrading, it's mind-polluting. I don't want my kids even to listen to this kind of garbage because it's whack. But that doesn't mean that these dudes can't have the freedom to sing any kind of music they want and to play any kind of music they want. Nobody says you have to buy it, or listen to it, or like it. So today it's the Stone Deaf album. Who's to say tomorrow it won't be the blues? And next week, Mozart, or this book, or that film. I built this place because I had the freedom to do it. And this is how I'm going to keep on keeping on.
Mom? Are you busy?
Well, I have an appointment at 4:30 to roll over. Otherwise...
Well, I need protest lessons.
You need what?
You know what's been happening at the record store.
Honey, if it doesn't happen in this room, I don't know about it.
Well, it's censorship, Mom. Pure and simple. Taking records off the shelves. Maxie and some other kids and I are trying to stop it, or at least find a way to say something about it. So we're putting together a protest. What are you smiling at? This is serious.
I know, sweetheart. I just haven't seen that fire in a long time. It's good.
Oh, I knew you'd understand. Dad didn't want to hear about it. You know how he gets. End sentences with the word period.
Is this something you really believe in?
Very much.
Will you make me a promise?
Sure.
Do as I say, not as I did. No one gets hurt. No mind expansion. And most importantly, no free love.
Mom!
Becca.
I think what the world needs is the spirit of the 60s, but the hairstyles of the 90s. Ever get the feeling you were born too late? You actually like the stuff? Well, everything meant something then. There was so much purpose. Everyone was trying to change the world. You'd walk out onto the street and everyone would be involved. It was a real revolution. I don't know. I just can't imagine living in a world without Velcro. Okay, if it was all so meaningful and everything, then how come your dad went plastic? I don't know. It's like he's become everything he protested against.
I don't know. Maybe once you get to a certain age, part of your brain dies. A quarter of a century living in Glenbrook would do it to me. He's lucky he's got any part of his brain left at all. It's so sad. It's like they had this wonderful treasure and then they forgot where they buried it. They didn't forget. They just stuck it in an old trunk. Ugh. Come on, Beck. We've got a lot of science to finish.
Aunt Gina?
Hi. I know that look.
Men. You can't live with them and you can't hunt them down and shoot them like wild dogs. I think Livy's getting sick of listening to me. And Daddy. You know, every time I try to talk to him about it, I can see these little curly hairs on his head turning white. The more father-daughter talks, he's gonna look like Kris Kringle.
I can just imagine what Becca's gonna do to him if the baby is a girl.
Gina, what am I gonna do?
It's just about wild thing, you make my heart sing.
Not funny.
Sorry.
He wants to move in with me. Why do you think I've been hanging out here all night? I know him. He's probably waiting outside in front of my apartment, sitting on his bike, picking his toes or something.
And you want to get rid of him?
Well, I didn't exactly say that.
Oh. Are we talking,
the best. I mean, you know when it's so good that you feel like your hair's gonna catch on fire?
I don't know if I can take this. So you don't know if you want to live with him?
I don't know what I want. I know I don't want to lose him. Gina, what do you think I should do?
I think you should give me your leftovers. Now, what you need is a girl's night out. No men. Just take the pressure off. Stop thinking about him. Get him out of your head. So what do you say, huh? You and me? Do up the town? No men?
Amen. Hour and 15-minute wait?
This place better be worth it.
I hope so. Kent and I tried to get in here a couple of days ago, and we couldn't. Everybody comes here.
Yo, sweet cake.
Where's the bin?
What bin? That's a lady. That's what they look like.
Excuse me, do you have another table?
Smoking or non-smoking?
Non-smoking.
No, this is the only one available.
Okay, smoking.
45 minutes?
What did I do, huh, Legs?
Worship you.
I say I'm ready to commit, and you avoid me like a hot tailpipe.
Look, I'm sorry. Kent, what are you doing here?
Eating. I gave the cook the night off.
You got a cook?
Read the menu. I figured you'd show sometime this year.
What kind of soup is doujoui?
I don't know. Vegetable, I think. Look, what do I gotta do? Just say it. You got it.
You have to give her some space.
I give great space. Wait, you're,
Gina Giordano.
Look, Gina, could you tell her that we're, like, perfect together? We're, like, finely tuned, honed and croned, crank and cam, rod and lifter, piston and...
Okay. I get the picture.
What do you say, sweet cakes?
What do I say? I say I'm not hungry.
Okay, good. She didn't say no, right?
Where's Abby Hoffman? Forget it. It's like you're serious about this.
Have you thought it all true? You tried every other avenue? You
can make like what?
Like writing an article for your school newspaper.
Ted, that's not gonna help.
Well, like collecting signatures and sending them to City Hall. Like going down there. You know, they have open meetings at the council. Did you know that?
Dad, this is the only way anybody's gonna listen.
How do you know that? Have you tried? You just told me you thought this whole thing through. I don't think you know what you're dealing with here.
Dad, we're not children.
Yeah, well, I think you're diving into something you don't have a clue about. A public protest is very powerful, but it's also very dangerous. And it should be your last resort. After the signatures, after the petitions, and after every other attempt has failed. Becca, listen to me. I don't mean to bring you down here, but things can happen. People start off with perfectly good intentions, but all it takes is for one of your buddies to toss a rock or for some cop to be having a bad morning, and people wind up getting hurt.
It's gonna be fine. This is not Trent State.
Kent State. Becca, please. I'm asking you. Don't do this.
Dad, we believe in this. We have to do it.
All right. I'm sorry, but I'm telling you, you're not going to do this.
What?
I forbid it. Period.
But Mrs. Thatcher said we could. She even gave us advice.
I'm sorry.
That is so totally unfair. You've got to be there. I can't, Maxie. It's just that simple.
You can't back out on us now.
You think I don't want to go? I've done all the organizing. I've made the phone calls. I've passed out 10,000 of these things. And now I'm going to be sitting at home watching cartoons. Come on, Becca. You think your parents had permission to go to Woodstock? They didn't go to Woodstock. You know what I mean. Maxie, I can't help it. You heard my dad. What should I do? You can stand by your conviction. I mean, this was your baby. You made the speech. You got us all fired up to do this thing. You're the one who said it was so important. And it is. But now you're chickening out. I am not. Do you think that every kid in the 60s had permission to go march in the streets? Or did some of them just decide to take the heat?
Hey, lay off, Maxie. It's not your parents on the warpath.
No, Tyler, it's okay.
Yeah.
I'll see you after class. Great, Mr. T.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Hi, Daddy.
Sorry I'm late. I got hung up. Wow, this doesn't impress that critic.
Yeah, if he ever shows. Paige, hey, who do I have to marry to get a refill on coffee here? Doreen? It's just for a couple of days, okay?
Daddy, please. Glad I can help.
Great. Thanks.
Save yourself.
Please don't. Please don't play with
that. Gail, stop that.
Hey, please don't pound on that. Would you like a boost?
I prefer a quiet cat in room.
He's gonna break the jukebox.
You're gonna break the jukebox.
I want the gun.
No.
Take anyone. I accept that one.
I'm sitting together.
Yeah. So.
Can I get a check, please?
Yeah, I'll
please.
Be right back. Be right.
That's mine.
So, you had a coffee, diet plate? Two. Dad. Doreen.
Gotcha, Mr. T.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the Glenbrook Grill. Table for one?
I look like a party of six. One will be fine.
Of course. Right here will be fine? May I get you something to drink while you peruse our fine menu?
I don't suppose you have any decent wines here.
Oh, I'm really sorry. We don't serve alcohol at the Glenbrook Grill.
I thought about getting a license, but nobody really seems to miss it, so...
It's a simple question requiring a simple yes or no.
No.
And tea. You do serve tea, don't you?
Best in Glenbrook.
Hot. With lemon.
Coming right up.
Order.
Yeah, just a sec.
That's enough.
Last chance for glory.
How often do you get a chance to stand up for something you really believe in? Okay, we'll see you after the protest then, okay?
The principal wants to see you.
The principal? But I didn't...
punished for your disobedience.
But I didn't go. I didn't go to the rally.
But you did go! Up here. That's the real crime.
This is so totally unfair!
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Where should I sit?
Oh, you can sit anywhere. Sit right there.
Doreen, my check, please.
Yeah,
I'll pay extra for it.
Doreen, a check here.
Okay. No.
Courtney, bring waters to booth number 3, okay?
Okay. Oh,
Doreen. Doreen, herbal tea for Mr. Gourmet. As hot as you can make it.
Scalding.
What'd you want?
Check.
Okay.
Excuse me, can I have a menu, please?
I will help you in 1 second.
May I have my tea, please?
Coming right up. Brewing it fresh.
Daddy, relax. I'll do it. Be nice. Stop that.
Someone will take your order in a minute.
Before they drive me insane.
I asked for lemon.
We're getting a fresh one for you.
Legs.
other chick was just at all...
I mean, I'm really trying. I thought if I brought your old man customers, I'm even involved in personal hygiene now. What else do you want me to do?
Grab an apron, go help your friend.
Keep your hands to yourself.
Fresh lemon? Would you care to order?
Is this your usual clientele?
Well, people do flock in from all over for our delicious special.
I suppose it's your business if you want to serve. I like to them. How's your steak special?
Great. The best. We only serve prime, grade-A meats here.
Fine. I'll have the steak special, blackened, medium.
Blackened?
Black. Oh, you can blacken a steak, can't you?
Oh, sure. Blackened? No problem.
Hey, that's enough. This is taking too long.
I'm sorry, please. About them things to draw and cover.
What's going on here?
See the man over there? He's a big food critic. He's going to write about us.
Really?
Yes. My dad is real nervous about it. Even though the food is great.
I guess it could mean a lot to him.
To our whole family. My mom is pregnant, and she has to stay in bed.
And you're hoping a good review will bring in more business?
Yes. If not, my father will have to go back being a construction worker. Please, don't go. Let me bring you some free drinks.
Oh, well, thank you. That would be very nice.
Can I get a cup of coffee, please?
Yeah, okay. One coffee. Corky. Tom?
Thanks, bud.
Can you give me another double cheese and chili? Hold on, just extra pickles.
Yeah. Blackened. He wants blackened. Tell him I blacken bogey, be the eyes. These are my kind of eagles. They appreciate what we serve here.
Hans, just grill it with some Cajun spices so it's black and crispy on the outside.
So is a cockroach black and crispy on the outside. Blackened is what you do to hide the flavor of cheap meats and fishes.
Hans, please. This could be very important. For all of us. Now just do it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I have to go mix the proper spices.
Well, Dad, you wanted busy, didn't you?
Yeah, give me one of those.
Yo, legs. This little guy over here needs some cream. Where is it?
In the creamer.
Oh. Come on.
Here's a nice fresh garden salad. Do you like French, Thousand Island, blue cheese?
What is this? I didn't order a salad.
I know. It's on the house. It's taking us a little longer to blacken your steak, so I thought we'd get you started with a nice...
Do I look like a rabbit? Take it away.
But
take it away. Is it so difficult? I'd just like you to bring me what I ordered. Hopefully in this century.
We're sorry to keep you waiting so long.
Boy, that guy's giving Dad a hard time. What a jerk.
Dad was too impressive for the review.
Well, I still think the guy's a genuine dork. I mean, what's he expect? We may not be the Four Seasons, but we really are the best for what we are. Listen, why don't you let us give you and your kids the biggest, juiciest hamburgers and the crispiest fries you ever tasted?
Oh, I think we'd like that very much.
Yeah! Thank you. Okay, which one of you handsome devils wants a piece of pie?
Yeah. Fish. Ned? Yeah. Can I please?
Yeah. Never mind.
Sit it down, Jack. It's on its way.
Neville, food.
Shout out, babe.
Blackened.
Your blackened steak special, sir.
One second. This steak is not cooked correctly. I asked for medium.
Well, how can you tell? You haven't even tried it yet.
Please, I don't have to taste it. I can tell. This is very overdone.
Of course, it looks overdone. It's black. It's just...
It's okay. No! Everything is not okay! My jacket is ruined!
Sir, I had to put out the fire.
I suppose I should know better than to set my shirt into a dump like this!
Look, I've tried to be cooperative. I've tried to be nice. But nothing is worth taking the abuse that you dish out. And I really don't care what you think of me or my dump. Because me and my good customers couldn't care less about your opinion. So why don't you just get out? And you can send me your dry cleaning bill.
Well, I never.
Yeah? Well, now you have. And don't let the door hit you on the way out. All right, Mr. T. Mrs. Thatcher!
Tyler,
what happened?
Oh, we were at the protest. You know the one at Silas?
Yeah.
I don't know what happened. The police came and Becca...
Becca? Where's Becca?
Let's just see it. She was in the crowd and I couldn't find...
Paige! Hot! Take over!
Be cool, Drew. It's over. No one got hurt. They didn't book you. That guy in the holding cell will never bother you again.
Dad, I can explain. Well, maybe I can't, but I have a feeling I'll have a long time to think about it. Like a week. Are we talking years here?
I was thinking maybe the, and the vinaigrette, or the Chateaubriand Poitou, or, possibly a robust, Pauly Fussé.
Ken.
Or, if you're into red, Cabernet Sauvignon.
Kent, you don't have to try to impress me.
Impress you? Hey, I'm impressing myself.
What I'm saying is, what you did for my dad, that was really sweet. I mean, I was really touched.
Right, legs.
It's the legs thing. Do you have any idea how sexist that is?
No. Okay, all right. Help me out here, Paige. I mean, which way is this conversation going? Am I gonna enjoy my food and get lucky, or am I gonna go home alone with Harper?
Neither. Just listen to me. I've been thinking.
Oh, I hate when you do that.
Would you listen to me?
Okay.
I find myself stupidly and ridiculously attracted to you. Don't ask me why.
Need I ask?
And I want to keep seeing you. But I can't move in with you.
No, I was moving in with you.
No, nobody is moving in with anybody. Can't look. I'm just barely 22. I just got my freedom and my independence. I'm just starting out. I need a chance to find out who the I in me is. Do you understand? Am I making any sense at all?
Not a word.
Doesn't matter. I know what I mean. Look, why don't we just eat and talk? Maybe later we can go for a walk.
I still smell like derelicts and delinquents.
I love the smell of misdemeanor on a man. Remember that time in Stansbury Park when we claimed it for the people? It was spring and the wind was up, and we felt so proud afterwards because our clothes smelled like tear gas. I think I told my parents I went to church.
That's not the point. The point is that she disobeyed me.
Okay, fine. Now, what are you going to do about it? Same thing your parents did? Same thing my parents did? Drew, didn't we learn anything by going through the 60s? Or is it all completely dead and buried in the garage? This is not about staying out too late. This is her cause. You come down too hard, you'll push her away. You know that.
It was all so clear when we were kids. The injustices, right or wrong. When did it get so muddy?
Well, Wally, what can I say? I don't believe it.
Believe it?
Oh, come on. You're hugging it. Let me see. A thriving business owned and run by an ex-construction worker and his charming family. The Glen Brooke Grill strives to please. Friendly staff, pleasant atmosphere, and despite the chaos caused by an obnoxious, unruly diner, I truly enjoyed what is probably the best burger in town.
All right.
Yeah, that's great.
What did I say, huh? Oh, I gotta run. Check, please.
Oh, no. I told you. The next one's on me.
Well, you're a man of your word.
Well, I hope you enjoyed everything. Say, weren't you in the other day? You sat in booth over there with a couple of kids?
Yes, but who can enjoy a meal with them around? The reviewer's right, you know. It's positively the best burger in town.
Well, thank you.
I hope your mom's feeling better.
Next time I come in, Thatcher, I'm going to sell you some ad space.
Well, maybe the next time you come in, I can afford it. And hey, thanks.
Don't mention it.
Well, now we're sure it wasn't the guy we thought it was. But who was in that day that had a burger and knew I used to be in construction?
I suppose it goes down as one of the seven great mysteries of life.
I guess we'll never know.
Come in.
Hey. Want to take a walk?
I would, but I'm grounded.
Special dispensation. Angie tells me she thinks Dan Webster can win his case.
Well, that would be great.
Yeah. She said, since the case is about community standards, a protest rally could really help him.
Are you saying what I did was okay?
I'm saying you made a difference. You fought for what you believed in. And that's something you should be really proud of. I know I'm proud of you.
Daddy, I'm sorry I disobeyed you. But I had to do it.
Yeah, I know. I guess I got some of my own regrets mixed up with your decision to protest. The time of my life was... It's really confusing. And it caused a big rift between me and my parents.
But it doesn't have to be that way, does it?
Nope. You're still my kid. As long as I'm alive, I'm going to do everything I can to keep you from doing something dangerous. But I'll stay out of your causes. As long as you let me know what you're doing and promise to stay on the right side of the law.
It's a deal.
I know you know this, but I don't say it enough. I love you very much. And nothing you say or do can change that. Not ever.
I love you too.
See that tray over there?
Yeah.
Bet you can't hit it.
Well, I bet you I can.
Ooh, nice one.
I missed.
Well, just barely.
Dad?
Yeah?
Am I still grounded?
Ask your mother.